Welcome to our Looker Studio tutorial. In this tutorial, we will learn to create data models, which is called blending in Looker Studio. We will learn how to create relationships among various tables. How to create calculated fields. How to add new fields and update data sources and blends. We will learn to manage data sources and blends using resource menu. And finally, we will create a dashboard, using our data blend or data model. We have placed our dataset named Atlas Furniture in Google Drive. It has multiple tables, and today we will use this file to create a relational data model and a report in Looker Studio. In Looker Studio, click on the Create button, and then on Report, to create a blank report. From Add Data to Report window, select Google Sheets. And select Atlas Furniture Dataset. From Worksheets, select any sheet, such as Channel. Click on the Add button. Click on Add to Report button, if you want to add this data to the report. Your table and its fields are available in the data pane. And here are the fields in the currently selected visual. We can delete this visual for now. Enter a name for your Looker Studio file here, and make sure to save the file after each change. If we go back to the Looker Studio, we will see that our file is placed there with the name we entered. To add another table, click on the Add Data below. Then go ahead and select Google Sheets. And then select the Atlas Furnitures and then the Gender Worksheet. Click on the Add button. On this window, click on the Add to Report button. Now the gender table is also added and is available in the data pane along with its fields. Use the same method to add all the remaining tables from the Atlas Furnitures workbook, one by one. You can manage your data sources from here. You can add data source. Edit existing data sources. Duplicate and remove data sources. And reuse these data sources in other reports as well. Since this is a multi-table dataset, we need to create a data model before we can create a dashboard. In a data model, we connect all tables with each other using relationships. In Looker Studio, it is called blending. To create a data model, go to Resources and click on the Manage Blends menu item. On the Blend screen, click on the Add a Blend button. Now, you can add various tables and create relationships among them to create a data model which can be used in your reports. First, add the Sales table, which is the main table and will be connected to all other tables. Add all fields with unaggregated values by which you want to group your data to dimension. Fields what you want to aggregate, such as number of units and price, will go to matrix. Fields with dates will go to the date range. In filters, you can add any field by which you want to filter the data. And this is how you will add all fields to the pane on the left side of available fields. You can leave the fields you don't want, and they will not appear in your report. Fields available in your data source will be listed in the extreme right pane. Now add other tables one by one and connect them to the sales table. Add the product table first. Add the product ID field to dimension, and cost and price fields to the metrics. Add the product code and category field to dimension as well. From configuration window, select left outer, and in the relationships, ensure that ID fields from both tables are linked. You can also enter table names here, which can be different as well. We will use their own names here. We have now linked one table to the sales table in our data model. Next, click on Join Another Table button, and add the location table to your data source. Ensure the location ID field is added to dimension. Expand the available fields and add other fields as well. Add city, country, and region fields to the dimension. Enter the name of the table. Click on the Configure Join button and select Left Outer Join. Ensure that both tables are linked using ID fields. Then click on the Save button and save the configuration. Next, add the gender table. Expand the available fields and add the description field to the dimension. Enter the table name. Configure the join to left outer using ID field as relationship and save the configuration. Now add the channel table to your data source. Add the ID and description fields to the dimension. Enter the table name. Configure the join using left outer join and the ID field as relationship. Here description fields are also added to the relationship, which is wrong, therefore delete them. Save configuration now. Now you will notice that there is no more join another table button, which means you cannot add another table after you have added 5 tables in your data model. And this is a serious limitation for us, as we have another table left to be connected to this model. And that is the status table. And this is why Looker Studio is not suitable for datasets with large number of tables. For now, enter the data source name, and click on the Save button to save the data source. And here in the blends list we have our Atlas Furnitures blend which we can use in our report. We can edit this blend at any time using the Edit button. And there is another way we can include the status table into this model without using blend. We can add the status field directly to the sales table in our source file. We already have the status ID field in our sales table. W can use the vertical lookup function to bring values from the status table using the status ID. Create a column named status. Enter the versus lookup function. Use the status ID as search key. Select both fields in the status table as range. Enter the column number from where you want to import values as index. Is sorted is an optional field and you can leave it blank. Press Enter to add the formula. Now, apply this formula to the entire column. Now we have status field in our sales table, which we can use without blending the status table. However, our model still does not have this field. We can make this field available using Manage Added Data Source menu item from Resources. The status field was added into the sales table, so edit that table. As you can see, there is no status field in this table. In the bottom left corner, click on the Refresh Fields button. After which a prompt will ask you if you want to apply changes or not. And it states that a new field named status has been found. Click on the Apply button to apply changes to this table. And now, our table has status field as well. When satisfied, click on the Done button to go back to the data source. And click on the Close button to close the data source. However, we are not finished yet. The status field is only added to the sales table, not to the data model we are going to use in our report. For that we need to go to Resources and click on the Manage Blends. Then we will edit our blend. Here, we do not have the status field in our data model, but if we expand the available fields in sales table, the status field is available there, which we can add to our data model now. And this is it, now we have the status field in our blend as well. Save and close the blend now. and expand the blend in the data pane to make sure the status field is available there now. If you don't see it, collapse the blend and expand it again, which will refresh the list and show the newly added fields too. Before starting your report designing, turn on the snap to grid option, which will ensure precision and accuracy. Without turning this option on, you will face difficulty in placing visuals symmetrically. Select a suitable grid size for your page. Select an appropriate page size from page setup. Go to Style tab and select a predefined page size or enter custom page dimensions. Clear the page and add a text box at the top of the page. Enter an appropriate title for your report here. Select an appropriate font size and make the text bold. Change the border color to black. And select border radius as well. From View menu, click on Fit All to view the entire page. From our data model, drag the country field to the report page. This will automatically add a map chart based on country field. Place this chart at the top left corner of the dashboard. Add the country field to size as count. This will display number of orders by country. We do not have the date field in our data model because we added date to date range only and not in dimensions. Go to the Manage Blends and expand the available fields in Sales table. Add the date field to dimensions as well. Save and close the blend data window. Collapse and expand the blend table and look for the date field. It should be available now. Drag the date field to the report page, which will automatically add a line chart. Place this chart below the map chart. Click on the Add Metric and add a new field. Enter sales in the name field, and in the formula multiply the price field with the units field. Click on the Apply button to add the field. Remove all automatically added fields now. Change the chart type to line and column chart, also known as combo chart. Add delivery charges to metric as well. You have two series now, both having left axis. Move one of them to right side. You can also change them to line or column as per your requirement. Create a copy of the combo chart and place it next to the map chart. Remove delivery charges from the metric. Change the chart type to pie chart. Replace the date field with the category field. Create a copy of the pie chart and place it next to the existing one. Replace the category field with the gender description field. Create a copy of the gender pie chart and place it below, next to the combo chart. Replace the gender description field with the channel description field. Copy this chart as well and place it in the bottom right corner. Replace the channel description field with the status field. Select all visuals and add to them a border and a border radius, just like the one we added to the title text box. Arrange the visuals appropriately. As you can see, the visual borders help a lot in bringing symmetry to the dashboard. Our report is now complete. And with this, we end our today's tutorial. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more insightful tutorials and updates.